But at the end of the day, he has to be the president of all Americans. And to some extent, all Americans have to believe the president is telling the truth. Yeah. And he can't make outlandish claims that can't be backed up. Yeah. And I think that's what he's struggling with. That's what he's going to have to deal with tomorrow, I think, Don.
To the other Jim on the panel, Jim Sciutto, good evening to you. So Sean Spicer went through a laundry list of press reports to try to back up what the president said. Here's an example, and then we'll discuss.
The New York Times reported the following. Sean Hannity went on Fox days after the election. Heat Street reported. Andy McCarthy writing in National Review. Sarah Carter from Circa reporting. On March 3rd, Fox News chief anchor Brett Baer said the following, quote, there's a report in June 2016, a Pfizer request by the Obama administration Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Court to monitor communications involving Donald Trump and several other campaign officials. Then they got turned down, then in October. Then they renewed it and do a startup wiretap at Trump Tower with some computer in Russian banks.
So, Jim, Jim Sciutto, it looks like an attempt to muddy the waters here. So please explain to us, what's the truth?
Listen, you know, it's the height of irony to have the White House spokesperson quoting from the press that the president has called the dishonest media repeatedly, right? You know, but forget that for a moment, because let's put up against that beyond, as Jim Acosta said, the ranking Democrat and Republican on the House Intelligence Committee, ranking Democrat and Republican on the Senate Intelligence Committee, but also the Republican Speaker of the House, the Attorney General, who's a Republican appointed by the President, the FBI Director, who have all said there's no evidence of this. They're briefed on the intelligence they've seen. There is no evidence. That's why on our screen we have said that this is a false claim by the President. It's false. There's no question. What you've had in recent days from the President and Sean Spicer is a redefining of the terms of the President's allegation. Fact is, the President alleged that President Obama ordered a wiretap on President Trump. You know, three elements there. President Obama did it, the target was Trump, and it was a wiretap. Now they're saying, well, you know, what he was really talking about was general surveillance where you might have had Trump advisors, not Trump himself, caught on the other end of communications with Russians. And the fact is, there is evidence of that. That's CNN's own reporting. That gets you into potentially dangerous territory, right? Because why then were there Trump advisors and members of the campaign repeatedly, and that's CNN's reporting, in contact with Russian officials and other Russians known to U.S. intelligence during the campaign? That's what there's evidence of, right? And that evidence was gathered during perfectly legal surveillance of Russian officials. That's what U.S. intelligence does. It listens to them to see what they're doing for the sake of U.S. national security. And sometimes U.S. persons are on the other sides of those phone calls. That information is minimized by U.S. law. That's all perfectly legal. It's what U.S. intelligence agencies do. But it then raises this other question, which is the subject of House and Senate and FBI investigations. Why were Trump advisors and campaign staff, et cetera, caught up in that?
Right.
So,
yeah.
You know, listen, no direction of this is particularly good for the Trump administration.
That's what I understand. The more the spin comes, the more I say it's not good if you know, no matter how you slice it, for this administration or for the president. And I want to get everyone in, so, and I should be, you know, my questions should be shorter. So brevity is a key here. Kirsten, did Sean Spicer do himself any good today? Did he do more harm than good?
Well, for himself personally, no, of course not, because I think every time he does this, he, you know, further erodes his own personal credibility, which he built up over a long time in Washington. But the thing I have to say is, I'm just wondering if anybody else is starting getting angry about this.
Yes.
I mean, about what Donald Trump has done here, because I think he has sent everybody on a wild goose chase. He's taken the entire apparatus, the government, you know, the entire U.S. government, basically, and sent them down this rabbit trail to hunt down something that never happened.
And he knows it's not there.
And he has no evidence that ever happened. And, you know, by his press secretary's own account, he learned it not really necessarily even from journalists. I mean, Sean Hannity doesn't even say he's a journalist. I mean, Andrew Napolitano does not describe himself as a journalist. I mean, these are people who have a perspective, right? And so he has the entire government apparatus hunting down something that probably never happened when there are actually real problems happening in this country that he should be spending his time on. So, I mean, it really is. And I don't understand why anyone is defending this.
Andre, why is anyone defending this? I mean, take us inside the president's head, if you can, here. Why would anyone defend this? I mean, anyone with any brain and anyone who has any idea of how this country works and intelligence has said There is no, as the president whispers because he does that too, there is no proof. I was watching CNN, and there was no proof. There is no proof.
Well, Don, number one, that's Sean Spicer's job. I mean, he is the Rambo of the media right now. He has taken on heavy artillery from every angle, and he is handing it right back to him. I admire the guy.
I've never seen a guy back down
to the press more than that guy. I've been the guy in the press conference.
Does anyone think that he's handing it right back? I feel embarrassed for him.
His job is not to say, oh, y'all are right and I'm wrong and the president's wrong. His job is to defend the president of the United States to the best of his ability and to give examples.
Go
ahead. Jim Shooter, what did you say?
He's not defending, he didn't get hired
by the Democrat Party.
Forget what we're reporting. I mean, we're reporting what the president's own appointees are saying about this claim.
Okay.
His attorney general's denying it. Yeah. The Republican Speaker of the House is denying it.
Nia, go ahead.
But I do think one of the things that Spicer is very effective at in that long soliloquy today, he is giving talking points to Trump supporters. He is giving talking points to Breitbart. He's giving talking points to Rush Limbaugh and Laura Ingraham and anybody who wants to talk about this and defend the president. So I think in that way, it's very effective.
Right.
And also, I think you have to wonder, is there going to be a consequence for this president with his credibility? And in some ways, possibly not, because at the same time, you've got Republicans who are working on health care. You've got him putting his budget out. So it's not clear that this is a president who thinks there are going to be consequences. There were certainly no consequences during the campaign when he said that, and there have been no consequences so far in terms of him spouting a ridiculous conspiracy theory.
I'm wondering if this is going to be different. Who knows? Jack Kingston, you get the last. Jack stayed around, by the way, because he had other things to do, and he so kindly stayed around. Jack, I'll give you the last one.
Let me say this. If you are a Trump person, you believe that all this discussion about Russia colluding with the Trump campaign is partisan bull. I think if you're a Democrat...
That doesn't mean it's true. Maybe someone should tell them it's not.
Well, but if you're a Democrat, you're looking at the exact same thing and saying that tweet was irresponsible and bad. I think this whole debate is a reflection
Republicans
of the
Republicans are saying it's irresponsible and bad.
Well, you know what? I hope in 2 weeks when...
do you think it was irresponsible? Hold on, Jack.
Wait a minute.
Whoa.
Let me ask...
No, a truth. Do you think it was irresponsible for the president to put that tweet out?
I think he should have said surveillance. So, and let me say, I read what
answer,
Obama...
But,
how,
come on,
how
Jack.
How Obama responded
me.
In a very legalistic way. Why didn't Obama respond?
Obama's spokesperson responded.
Don, even if he had said surveillance, even if he had said...
Even if he had said surveillance in those tweets,
he was comparing President Obama to Richard Nixon and trying to pull off a Watergate-style operation.
And Joseph McCarthy.
Heat of the campaign,
Is that not what the Democrat Party is doing right
please.
Now? Is that not what the Democrat Party is doing when they say that there was collusion?
There's no cleanup on Fifth Avenue on this one.
I don't think so.
There's no cleanup on Fifth Avenue on this one. I think this is just, you know, if the president could go back and delete these tweets, wherever it is on his staff that he dictates these tweets to, could go back and delete those tweets.
I think it's all leading
I think
to
he'd be doing
one
a service
big
to every American
where he
in
says,
country.
"Okay, I might walk back what I said about President Obama, but you got to walk back what you said about my campaign." In two weeks, he won.
That's
in 2 weeks, when okay, Richard and then Devin Nunes
oh my God!
Back,
now we go down the rabbit hole. Should he say, "I'm going to walk back what I said about birtherism,"
and
I'm going to walk back what I said?
Richard
oh my God!
In 2 weeks, when he says there was
Jack,
no collusion, I just wonder.
Jack,
I'm going to take you to Washington, and get you to hug Devin Nunes when he says there was no collusion in two weeks.
To be continued.
Oh, boy.
That's why I love
this
show.
Jim,
First Amendment.